I'm Sam. This is
Danny.
And we're mad scientists.
Today we're doing an experiment with cold and hot water where it vacuum compresses the can.
Our materials are two pop cans, a timer, tongs, and hot and cold water with one bowl. So, what are we all doing this for? Well, let's find out. Danny?
We're doing this to figure out which temperature of pop can will crush faster or crush at all. So Sam, what is our hypothesis?
Well, Danny, I'll tell you our hypothesis. We believe the pop can with the warm air, with the more energy, will have a faster time of crushing the can because there's a bigger temperature difference than the cold air on the outside. This means that when the steam hits the cold water, the cold air on the outside becomes warmer, which then crushes the can! So, you may be wondering what our constants and variables are. Well, our dependent variable is seconds on our timer.
Our constant variables are the temperature of the cold water and the type of cans that we use.
Our variable is the temperature of hot water in the two different pop cans. Our first temperature is 200 degrees, and then our second temperature is 72 degrees. Moving on to the procedure, Danny.
Our first procedure is to get the materials.
Step two.
To warm the water till it is 200 degrees Fahrenheit. Step three.
Freeze cold water till it reaches 32 Fahrenheit.
Step 4.
Put the warm water in one of the pop cans. Step 5.
Put the cold water in one of the bowls.
Step 6.
Take the thermometer and check both the pop can and the bowl's temperature.
Step 7. Get your timer and be ready to start the timer as soon as the pop can touches the water.
Step 8.
Carefully and quickly place the pop can into the bowl. Step 9.
Repeat once, but with the temperature of 72.
Degrees. Okay. Step 10.
Compare the times with times of each trial. Step 11.
The one with the fastest time or with the slowest seconds is the fastest. Hi, we're going to be putting 4 tablespoons into the cup. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just to let you know, we did this for both cans. 190,
200.
Get your timer ready. Once it touches the water, start the timer. 1 minute or 1 second and 18 milliseconds. Let's see what happened.
It crushed it, but it felt good. That's it. So now this one has reached 72 degrees.
Now let's see what happens with the 72 degree water Fahrenheit. Nothing.
Wait. Our conclusion is that the 200 degrees can crush faster than the 72 degrees.
We know this because the hot air becomes a liquid, then it crushes slash condenses the can. Because of the cold air on the outside wants to be equal with the warm air. The cold air on the outside of the can becomes the warm air, which expands, then crushes the can.
Bam!